In 1889, the Ugolino Golf Club in Florence, Italy was founded by the English community who migrated to the area. Then, in 1934, the club moved to this charming location showcasing the scenic Tuscan landscape.
It was built by two Scottish golf designers, and ever since, nothing really has changed very much over here. So the club is one of the oldest. The golf course itself is the third oldest in Italy.
You would think that at just over 6,200 yards and playing to a par of 72, this course would be a pushover. Well, far from it. It's characterized by smallish greens along with sloping fairways. It's a challenge that truly keeps you on your toes. It's a spirited, healthy walk on hallowed grounds where you use brains and precision.
The landscaping is very beautiful, but the golf course is tricky, not very long for modern standards, but most people really enjoy it because of the olive trees and the pine trees and all the vegetation is around here. Technically, it's difficult because you never have a flat lie, so you always have a ball above, below, sideways. So even if it's not that long, it is difficult to play.
Stay balanced in your swing like our friend Niccolo here and have a solid short game and you will score well. You just don't see courses like this in America or many other places for that matter. There is so much to see and do in the historic city of Florence, and naturally, there's an abundance of wonderful food and drink. Yes, we're talking about wine, of course. It all adds up to one memorable experience.
We get quite a few Americans coming over. Mostly there are people that are traveling to Florence for cultural reasons. They happen to stay in nice hotels and they ask to play around the golf, and so they might pop over. And they get quite enthusiastic about the golf course because they don't expect something so different in a way.
Italian Golf Hall of Famer Federica Dasso knows Ugolina better than anyone, as she started playing here at the tender age of 6. Later, she became an accomplished touring player as an amateur and professional traveling all over the world. Pro tournaments have come here too. The great Seve Ballesteros had an exceptional moment on Ugolino when the Italian Open was staged here in 1983.
He needed to chip in the par 5 to make eagle to go to the playoff. So he was, with the second shot, a little bit long past the green. Knowing that he had to make it, he did. So he hit a little chip and run with a 9-iron, and the ball went into the hole.
Although Seve didn't win the playoff, it was still magic, just like this layout. It's a treasure that is the heart and soul of what Italian golf is all about. At times, it may be a challenge to keep your wits at Ugolino Golf Club, but once you do, the rewards are boundless.